lecture will be continuation of previous one, naturally, when we considered this meaning discussion of the BEC. The first assumption is that the wave function for the ensemble of atoms is given by the product of identical functions, and through the minimization of the energy functional, we get the equation for the function phi I. And this equation is called Gauss-Pitayesky equation, and it has the form of kinetic energy plus external potential plus term which is called unit field interaction. So you have G0, number of atoms minus 1, but for the large number of atoms we assume this is equal to n. Each atom feels the screening from the rest of the cloud. And this is equal chemical potential of the system. And we know that G0 is related to the mean field, scattering length. So we have 4 pi is square divided by mass of each atom times scattering length. And we consider two scenarios. First one, when the G0 is attractive, and the solution to such a problem in the approximation that the interactions are much stronger than the kinetic energy is given by the Thomas Fermi problem. So this is density in the direction. This is Thomas Fermi. Small guy. The first step, we should get the equation which describes the dynamics of our system. And the very intuitive approach, we can replace the chemical potential by the time derivative of the wave function extending to the right. So we have time-dependent Gauss-Witterski equation. Consider that delta phi contains two parts. First part is the part which is along the wave function phi zero, and the second part which is orthogonal to the phi zero. So we can always make such a from this, we can conclude that this is the pure imaginary wave function. So we can conclude that if this is pure imaginary wave function, so this is only the change of the global phase for the phi zero. So we are interested only in this part, which describes the whole dynamics. So you can write now that phi zero is equal to beta plus so what we do now? We put this guy here. And site. I just make the sketch for the calculations. Decide on the side. This is the first step. In the second step, you project whole equation onto the subspace, which is orthogonal to the static ground state. So we can get where operator L is quadratic form and it has AGP diagonal. We decide what it is. G0 times M particles, Q operator, Y0 square Q. The last step are the terms corresponding to the changing the external potential. S is the product of the change of the external potential. System, if you have 5 eigenvectors and the left one are only just conjugated. From the column we put in to the role and made the Hermitian conjugate. This is not the case in this system. However, we can find the relation between left and right eigenvectors. And this relation is based based on two symmetries of this operator L. First symmetry is related to the sigma X matrix. So this is 0, 1, 1, 0 and sigma Z matrix, which is 1, 0, 0, minus 1. As another exercise, this is straightforward, I can show that operator L fulfills this symmetry and fulfills this symmetry. Those two symmetries allow us to study in the systematic way the relation between right and left eigenvectors. However, this is quite time-consuming algebra. This is straightforward. So let's give the prescription for the left eigenvector of this problem. And the left eigenvectors time-dependent functions. Next, we have two eigenvectors to the zero energy of this operator L. And we have also dk. So now, instead of finding just the delta phi, we have to find the equations for uk, dk terms. To make it short, solution of this equation. And S of k is related to the initial change in the travel coefficient. So I just swap the basic steps, which are quite straightforward, but require some calculations. Nevertheless, we found the solution to the initial problem. We have ground state, we perturbed it with the change of the potential, and we asked the question, what are the modes propagating through the whole density? And the old modes can be found by finding the eigenvectors of the operator L, so these terms, and the amplitudes are the solution of this equation. So we can have a look at some particular example, which is quite interesting. This is VC in the box potential. Smaller than interaction term. This is the linear the spectrum, which is part of the form of life. Gives rise to the existence of the superfluidity in the bees. And we can look at this in the next few minutes. Are there any questions up to this point? Whether or not this is just standard prescription for the stability analysis of the nonlinear equation. So we found the energies of the modes, and we can relate them to the superfluidity. And how it can be seen? So the friction in the system is due to the fact that we have some medium, and we have some particle propagating with momentum, velocity v and mass m. The friction in the situation when it will exceed some mode with momentum k, and it will fix the recoil energy from this kick of the 8 bar k strength. So basically, kinetic energy, energy in the system has to be conserved. So we have energy of the initial momentum minus the kick divided by 2m plus the propagation of the kicked mode. Okay, I didn't say about one thing. Knowing the dispersion relation, we can calculate the defined sum velocity in the system. C divided by the decay of the 1/h. So this is fusion. And this is the sound velocity of the bees. So from this, cannot excite the system and cannot give any mode. Without this mode, it doesn't fix friction and it frees free. But one, it has a lot of energy allowing to make the propagation of some different mode. It feels frequency energy of this momenta and it feels friction. So this is the basic mechanism for the superfluidity. And this is for the case of the repulsive interactions. While for the attractive interactions, the situation is a little bit different, because we can expect that the BC will collapse. But it won't collapse as long as the argument of the under the square root will be larger than 0. So should be larger than 0. And the box potential, you know, that the momenta are quantized. given scattering trend, there is only finite number of particles which can be stored in the VSU with the negative interaction. So it means that we cannot put as much as we want the particles because the VSU will collapse. And this condition has to be fulfilled for the experiment, which is the most tricky part for preparing the attractive interaction VSU. And at this moment, this is everything I wanted to tell you about VEC in the mid-field description of the stability of the cloud, and we can make very fast break for the next part, which will be in some sense separate because it will be about the microscopic description.